A wintry atmosphere surrounded the house. The soundlessness of the area suggested it was empty. When finding a boot, one wonders what became of the foot. The key, which seemed to be meant for a padlock, bore an inscription reading Clouté et Fils. A company name. Better keep an eye open. Businesses weren't exactly numerous around these parts. money in a jar. What a shame. Carl would have loved cookies. A pay stub for some undoubtedly harsh lumberjack work. Alexandre Blais felled trees and chopped woods for Cloutier et Fils. The sheets were in such a way that indicated a rude awakening, followed by a hurried escape. What had happened here? Carl's big fingers prevented him from reaching the key. Thank you. crowbar was stuck under the lift. Notwithstanding Carl's imposing stature, car lifting wasn't part of his skill set yet. The note explained that the garage and the store couldn't be supplied with electricity at the same time. The store and its surroundings still held their secrets, and he didn't like to miss out. Thank you. The air was freezing, right down to the bone. Felt a cool, tingling sensation in his back. Another vision took over him. Something was hidden under the stairs. The man grabbed his rifle. Carl felt a sense of dread in him. Perhaps their spousal relationship had been cooling down lately. It seemed like secrecy was commonplace in this house. Carl felt the cold slowly dissipate and was brought back to reality. Giselle was now only ice, and all that was left of her voice was a diary. She confided in this diary, amongst other things, the tragic story of a young woman, a victim. Was this what she was hiding? Looks like the holes in that puzzle are there to stay. The pot was cold, and the stew inside wasn't cooked. It's likely that poor Giselle was slow cooking it before she got snapped. What a waste. Carl had seen that kind of safe before. With its double-layered security system blending letters and numbers, its code couldn't be broken by the common burglar. The general store, along with several more infrastructures in the area, had been acquired by wealthy industrialist William J. Hamilton. Perhaps the village should be rechristened Hamiltown. Ah, moving. What a pleasant activity. Of course, you'll find the record player only to find the records weeks later in some random box. What a mess! Clearly, there was some major revamping work underway here. The place looked barely habitable. Beautiful portrait of Gilles and Giselle, bound together by the chains of conventional love. A nice white coating would restore the room to its charm of olden days. Many boxes scattered about. Carl didn't need to summon his detective training to quickly figure that the Lachances had just moved in. Beautiful portrait of Gilles and Giselle, bound together by the chains of conventional love. A nice white coating would restore the room to its charm of olden days. Many boxes scattered about. Carl didn't need to summon his detective training to quickly figure that the LaChausses had just moved in.
Thank you.
A true Catholic always strives to keep lowly temptations at bay. Obviously, Carl thought, someone in this house wasn't doing a good job at upholding the Holy Bible's teachings. Carl was no burglar. He didn't need to resort to petty techniques such as window breaking to find his way in. A good detective simply looks for keys where gullible souls hide them. What was even the point of locking your door if everyone hid their key in the same place? Carl was starting to feel like his investigator life lacked challenge. The house smelt like incense, the kind that reminds you of the good Lord, of peace. Good Paul VI, appearing papal. His crooked fingers gave the impression he was about to bestow a miracle. Religion was very influential throughout Quebec many years ago. Indeed, it was surprising that Carl did not come across a single chapel since arriving here. Who knew that giraffes thrived in the North Pole? The craze for toys was stupefying. Love of religion and ancestors was rooted deep inside the hearts of Canadians of old, to which the Bedards appeared to be closely related. The empty cradle sent an eerie feeling down Carl's spine, as if minutes ago someone just grabbed the baby and made a run for it. The Bedards had vacated the premises. Carl gathered they would be of no help. Dreamcatchers originated from First Nations legends. They were used to trap nightmares. The perfect cookie-cutter Catholic family, most likely attending church every Sunday. It was so cold, already Carl did not feel his toes anymore. The cold was burning Carl. He would not hold up much longer. He had to warm himself. It was a classic Canadian house, except for the absent horde of kids that would normally be swarming about. Just one more move and White is checkmated. Game over. It seems the game was abandoned right before the final strike came down. Simone de Beauvoir, Claude Lévi-Strauss, Hannah Arendt, Roland Barthes. Carl was surprised by the literature filling this liberal-leaning bookcase. Could there really be intellectuals dwelling in this far-off land? The photograph was snapped not too far from here, Carl noticed. The couple seemed to be very good friends. A picture of Wilfred in his youth. Carl figured right away that the man must have been some kind of wildlife officer. All manners of clothing were gone, as if the Droits drove out of town with their closet in tow. Not a single weapon was left. All of them were gone. Never thought he would be dancing with the wolves. Thank you.
Thank you.